first Indigenous millennial is an award-winning playwright, a comedian who pushes boundaries and is never afraid to speak her mind.
You can't divorce your identity or your family or your history from who you are and the way that you see the world. Because ultimately, it's like you're taking your guts and you're putting it on a page. My name is Nakkiah Lui. I'm a Gamilaroi and Torres Strait Islander woman.
Have you always been proud of being an Indigenous woman?
Like, I was always brought up to be very proud of being Aboriginal. However, you know, I went to school in Western Sydney, probably from the ages of 6 to 16, I had an Abbo joke every single day of my life. And that makes you feel like shit. If society thinks that you're worthless, you're going to think that you're worthless.
Is comedy your way of bringing people in, bringing the audience in?
What I love about comedy is I think laughing is the best way to rebel.
Today, I'm getting a sneak peek of how that comedy is made on the set of Nakkiah's new TV show.
I had a meeting with ABC and they were like, got any ideas? And I was like, well, I have this pitch.
That pitch involves an Aboriginal girl whose vagina convinces her to follow her dreams and become an ice skater.
You know, she learns that through her, like, kind of big black mook coming to life. I always kind of want to create work that I wish I had when I was younger. It's like 100 kilos and, you know, brown, and from like Mount Druitt with like a lift. I remember so vividly looking at my white lace curtains one day and looking at my skin and just crying, because I really did never think that I could ever do what I wanted to do. And I do believe if you can see it, you can be it.
Nakkiah has kindly offered to teach me the basics of ice skating. The very basics.
Oh my God. Ah.
How are we getting the hang of it?
Oh Jesus.
Ah. Oh, are you okay?
Oh, well that was terrifying. So let's talk about sex.
Okay, I'm your girl.
What do people need to know about dating Nakkiah Lui?
I don't know, the most important thing is basically like being able to put up with a lot of family members. A few years ago, I was really worried that I'd never dated an Aboriginal guy. And then I did date an Aboriginal guy, and then it turned out he was my cousin. So that was like nightmare horror story.
Did that actually happen?
Yeah, he was like fourth cousin.
I mean, that's fine though.
Is that fine? Like in my tribe, it was like a definite no-no.
So you're an urban Koori like me. Do people ever assume that you have these kind of mystical or spiritual qualities?
Yeah, like we're, you know, some kind of like brown unicorns running around Australia. You know, there was one lady who was like, I knew my dad was Aboriginal because he liked to, he could squat for hours, I think were her exact word. If you're not like that, people then doubt your Aboriginality for not being like that, because it's a whole
for not being able to squat for long periods of time.
Yeah, look, I got bad knees.
Do you think of yourself as an activist?
I think, you know, all Aboriginal people are activists because our identities are so politicized. I experienced domestic violence in my early 20s, and I remember in that moment, and I'm standing there with this, like, you know, bloody lip and whatnot, all I could keep thinking was, like, you stupid Aboriginal girl. And I felt like I'd let my entire family and community down. And then I realized that I've obviously viewed Aboriginal women and Aboriginal women who've been victims of domestic violence in a certain way where I've kind of blamed them for it. Of course you're going to think those things about yourself if that is the myth or the story that society is feeding you.
What about the label of Indigenous leader?
Oh, I hate that. I hate this idea of leaders and leadership. People who really lead are those who practice what they preach, and they just do.
We are celebrating 50 years since the 1967 referendum. Do you think that your life is markedly, noticeably better than your mum's or your grandma's?
It astounds me that, you know, like my mum lived in a tent, like she was a fringe dweller. In saying that, I have family that can't walk down the street without being harassed by the police. You know, I've lost a lot of family members to suicide in the last 2 years. There's a few of us who are lucky enough to be haves, but that doesn't mean that there's still a whole heap of have-nots.